Hey, this is John and William from StubGroup. StubGroup is one of the top premier Google partner advertising agencies in the world, and we help businesses dominate Google Ads and grow their profit online. And we love tracking the success of our campaign so we can show exactly where that profit is coming from. But sometimes things go wrong. Conversion tracking code on a website breaks, or a web developer accidentally removes it, or a whole host of different things. And that creates problems because it removes our ability to see how things are working properly. And it can also impact any automated bidding strategies that we are using on behalf of clients, where we're telling Google, hey, this is what's working, get us more of that. And then suddenly Google thinks that something is working that's not working, and it starts getting a lot more of that for us, but that's not what we want. So long story short, William, when this type of thing happens, what do we do on the account management side of things to try and make sure that we're informing our strategies and making sure that Google knows not to optimize based upon bad conversion data?
Yeah, absolutely. So Google has a great feature that allows you to exclude conversion data that may be inaccurate for whatever reason. I had a client recently who was making changes in the back end of their site, and they removed the tracking for a portion of the forms that were taking place. And so it's under reporting now to Google Ads the number of conversions that are taking place. So this feature, data exclusions, allows us to tell Google when we're using an automated bid strategy, whether that's target CPA, maximize conversions, target ROAS, etc., and tell Google, hey, we don't want you to take this data into consideration for this date range because of this outage issue or technical issue. So let me show you how this works. So if you go to tools and settings, and then under bid strategies, you'll find advanced controls and data exclusions, and we can easily set up an exclusion here so that Google isn't taking into account incorrect data or conversion data and optimizing based off of that. So again, they give a helpful note here. This is just meant to be used for outages or issues with tracking. You wouldn't want to use a data exclusion because of poor performance that you may have gotten over, you know, a number of days or whatever extended period that may have been. This is to be used for just periods where the conversion tracking wasn't accurate. So we'll put in a name here. So this would be, you know, broken form tracking or whatever makes the most sense for you. And then you can give a more detailed description if that's helpful. And then you'll want to set the start date and end date for this. So if the outage happened on, you know, the 14th of May, and then you're able to resolve it, you know, by the 17th, it would exclude the data within that date range. Now, it is important to keep in mind whatever the typical conversion delay is for your account. So in this account, it's typically about 1 day. For others, it may be longer. You may have, from when the impression happens to when the conversion takes place, could be 3 days, 7 days, etc. You'll want to take that into consideration when you're setting up the date range so that you're accurately including all of the appropriate time. Once that's in place, you can choose which types of account. You can apply it to the account as a whole: search, display, shopping, performance max. The data exclusion is not applicable to video and app campaigns, so you wouldn't be able to apply it to those. But for search, display, shopping, performance max, it works with these. You can set it the account. You can set it for specific campaigns. If you had just one in particular that the issue was happening in, you can set it there, and then at the devices. This was on the website, and so it was impacting desktop traffic, mobile traffic, but if it was mobile specific or desktop specific, you could make those changes there and then apply them, and Google would exclude that date range for those campaigns, whatever the settings that we've put in place there, so they can optimize correctly based off of real conversion data and not from when an account may have been underreporting or overreporting for the number of conversions.
Awesome. And so does this, if we were to do that data exclusion and then go back to the campaigns area and take a look at the number of conversions that are reported for this date range, is Google actually changing that number on the front end that we can see, or is that still staying the same?
That's a great question. So it's not going to retroactively change any conversion numbers. So if you go back to the campaigns, you're not going to see that number increase or decrease. If there's still other conversion goals that are firing correctly, those would still be visible there. But whatever date range is in place in the data exclusion, Google's not going to apply those to its optimizations. But the numbers that you see there are still going to stay the same. So if it's underreporting, it's not going to retroactively go up. And if it's overreporting, it's not going to be able to be brought down within the interface. But Google will be told not to use that information in the automated bid strategies so that you can get as accurate information as possible.
Awesome. So back end change only. Don't freak out if you make this and then still see the same number of conversions that you saw before this. Very cool. And let's say, speaking of mistakes, let's say someone mistakenly puts the wrong date range when they add a data exclusion. Can you go back and remove that data exclusion, or is that set in stone once you save it?
No, that's a great question. So you can go back once these are in place. So we can go and remove it and delete it entirely or edit it and start over. And you can make those updates easily whenever you realize that needs to be adjusted.
William, thanks so much for sharing that. And if you're watching this video and you have questions about conversion tracking or performance or automation or anything in your Google Ads account wanting to improve your performance, do a better job, we at StubGroup, we'd love to talk with you. You can reach out through our website, stubgroup.com, start a conversation. We'd love to see what's going on and see if there are any ways that we can help.
Hey, do you want to dominate Google Ads and grow your business? Subscribe to this channel and we'll help you learn how. You see, we've made almost $500 million for our clients from Google Ads. In fact, according to Google, StubGroup is one of the best performing Google partners in the world. Subscribe to our channel for more videos like the one you just watched and learn how to dominate Google Ads, increase profits, and grow your business too. And check out the description below for your own free Google Ads profit plan, customized for your business.